Ollie, you're the voice of this World Floorball Championship. How did you end up in floorball?
What an interesting question. Yeah, how did I end up in floorball? Well, I mean, the first thing, I called floorball for the first time at the World Games in 2017 in Wrocław. I was working for the Olympic Channel there, but I'd had some conversation with John, the IFF, for a while. It was a sport I was really, really keen to work on. And when I got the chance to do the bronze and gold medal games out in Wrocław, I was delighted. And of course, it was a great way to start calling the sport, because you had that fantastic Switzerland-Sweden final there that the Swiss were 5-2 up, and suddenly it all turned around. And it was just a great way to begin. I absolutely fell in love with calling it because of that first experience.
You mentioned you were doing reports or reporting for the Olympic Channel. What other sports are you an expert in?
Well, I'm always nervous of claiming to be an expert in any sport. I think I'm an expert in no sports, but a fan of lots of them. I worked out in Rio 2016 for Olympic Broadcasting Services, and I'm about to go and do the Winter Olympics for them. In total, I've covered over 20 sports live, some of them a lot more than others. I've done a lot of gymnastics, Davis and Fed Cup tennis. At the Olympics, I covered football, wrestling, tennis, table tennis, badminton and canoe slalom. So a real mixture of things. I started life as a wrestling commentator, and a lot of people still come to me for wrestling related commentary. But for me, I love doing loads of different sports. That's what's really exciting.
You came across plenty places with all these sports, I guess. Do you have what's your most memorable story from all these events you have been to?
Interesting. I've certainly been to a lot of really interesting places. In terms of a sporting story, I'm going to say when a Norwegian chap called Stig Andre Berger won a bronze medal in Rio 2016 in the Olympics. And for me, it was one of the most privileged moments to get to commentate. Now, I think it was something like the 59 kilogram weight class in Greco-Roman wrestling. But what was interesting was that Berger had found out on his way back from a qualification tournament that his mother was terminally ill. And she passed away very shortly before the start of the games. Berger promised her that he will win her a medal. And this is a guy who was in his 30s. He was not considered to be a real favourite to take a bronze medal. He competed at two previous games, hadn't won anything. And then he gets to Rio and we watch his journey through the tournament, and he gets to that bronze medal match and he wins a bronze medal in the tightest fashion. It was so dramatic and so moving, and to see his celebrations when he won the bronze medal, for me to get to voice that as a commentator, just because of the humanity behind the story, I felt very honoured to get the chance to put into words his triumph.
Awesome. Thank you very much for sharing that great story. There's now 3 days left of the tournament. What do you expect over these last 3 days? Do you think you have already seen everything in floorball?
I don't think you've ever seen everything in any sport, and I think that's what makes sport so wonderful. I just want to say how much I love this sport. I hope it comes across in my commentary that I feel a genuine passion for what I'm calling. I'm no expert in the sport. I know that it's not a sport that I have played, but the respect I've got for it, the skill that these people have, and actually also I want to say thank you to the floorball family who've been lovely and reached out with such positivity and tolerance for my lack of knowledge. But so in terms of what I expect, look, Sweden were remarkable in their game against Latvia. They were just a joy to watch, a masterclass. I think it's going to be interesting to see what happens when Finland plays Slovakia, because sometimes that extra roar from the home fans can make a team come alive. I think it'll be what floorball always is: very fast, very furious and very exciting.
Ollie, thank you very much, and we're really looking forward to have you for the last few games. Thank you.